Hi guys, welcome to Tots and Moms. I'm Kavita Prashant. In today's video, we are going to talk about how to stop breastfeeding, especially a few tips and methods which are ideal to be followed. Also, I'm going to share few tips for a mother who can safeguard herself from the pain and all things involved during this process. So, breastfeeding for a baby is not just a food, but acts as a pacifier too, and hence it becomes very difficult for a mother to wean off her baby. Sometimes it is that difficult that an intervention is required. So we'll talk about ideal methods here. Before that, let's move on and understand the guidelines. If you think about stopping to breastfeed, you must know these things. So till when should you ideally breastfeed your baby? 2 years. World Health Organization and Ministry of Health in India suggest this. So till 6 months, it should be exclusive breastfeeding, which means that nothing else apart from breast milk is given to baby. Till 1 year, it should be continued feeding, which means that the same breast milk remains the main source of nutrition, but along with that solids are given. And till 2 years, it is complementary feeding, which means that breast milk needs to be continued along with solids. So this is the ideal suggestion, and in case you are going to stop it prior before an year, it should be only formula milk. If breast milk is stopped, alternate is only formula milk, nothing apart from that, until 1 year birthday. So if at all you think of stopping it post 1 year, also the baby or the toddler must not be forced to have cow's milk, because later it is not required. Till an year, if you are stopping breast milk, which is the best food for baby till an year, you can alternate it from formula, then not required. Then next thing you must remember is no cow's milk, goat's milk, donkey's milk is required. I'm not making fun of many custom and cultures in India which follow to give this, but these are not to be given. If I have heard that many of them dilute cow's milk 4 times of what it is, adding water, and then feed the baby. There is no nutrition at all, and you need not do that. Solids when you stop breast milk is ideal, nothing apart from that, post 1 year. And if you have decided to stop breastfeeding, you must understand your baby's or toddler's changes. If the baby is crying a lot, not sleeping at all, becoming very clingy, and not eating food as well, and you can see symptoms of any sickness or illness, then it's not the right time. Maybe you will have to postpone it a bit. So please be prepared for all of these things. Now let's talk about various ways where you can stop breastfeeding. One is child-led weaning. Post 1.5 or 2 years, when baby gets distracted, takes his face off from the breast, does not like to drink milk but like solids more. So these are some signs that your baby is overcome the age of breast milk, but ideally it should be after 2 years. If you are doing it prior, I mean, I would suggest at least till 18 months you will have to insist your baby to feed breast milk. And then is sudden weaning. This is most popular in India, unfortunately, because this is not an ideal method. What happens is suddenly one day the best source of nutrition for a baby is stopped, and suddenly one day you try to change the process of your body, and your body succumbs to it. There will be a lot of problems like breast engorgement, pain and fever due to this, infection, mastitis, or it can also be breast abscess which needs to be operated. Baby is hindered of the nutrition. He is emotionally not in a good phase of life, because suddenly he has lost something. He gets clingy, angry, frustrated, anxiety will be too much in a baby. So all these things makes it one of the worst method to be followed. I understand in India it is a tradition where many of them apply Karela ka paste, neem paste. There are so many ointments available in the market now, or anything bitter, chilies added, applied on mother's breast, and then the baby is forced to do that. Later you will only face a lot of issues. You must understand that. Also, again, I would repeat that I am not making fun of any custom or tradition. I am trying to give you knowledge on what are the other ways, what can happen if you do this. Also, many women are insisted on sending the baby away to in-laws place for a few days or mother's place for a few days, so that baby is not there with you, baby will not feed, and there is a sudden weaning happening. So this again is not an ideal situation. Now baby is losing on two important things in his life. One is breast milk and another one is mother. So staying away in that phase is not an ideal thing. Now the best thing I would say is mother-led gradual weaning. So in this format, what happens is mother would reduce the number of feed one by one slowly, so that the baby adapts to it and mother adapts to it, and both their bodies get adjusted to it without having much of a problem. I would say no problem, I wouldn't say that, but mostly there is not going to be any problem. Okay, so what happens here is mother would stop. If you are feeding 15 times a day, would reduce it to 13, 12, 11, like that. And this also post 1.5 year, 2 year, I would suggest. Anything more than 1 year is great. In India, in current situation, mothers stop feeding before 6 months. So for them, doing it till 1 year, 1.5 year is great. So at least do till then, and later stop one feed at a time. This is how the baby adjusts to it. Here, other source of nutrition can be added on so that the baby is not suffering. And for mother to come out of all that problem, this is an ideal way again. And best part, while researching on this, best thing I got to know is your milk would be very strong, immunity level would be so high while you stop the milk, because the immunity, which is divided in 10 feed, will come to 5 feed when you reduce it. Okay, slowly the baby towards the end gets all the immunity which is required to his body. So this was amazing read for me and knowledge. Though I followed this with Disha, I followed mother-led gradual weaning only, but I did not know this. So this was something amazing. You have decided to stop breastfeeding. How to ensure that your kid is not suffering emotionally or physically due to this change? First tip is ensure his nutrition is taken care, because the main food which gave immunity, breast milk, is going to be stopped. Include dairy products, include dry fruits, fruits, vegetables, good pulses, greens in his diet, and make it a wholesome one. Then change his daily routine. If you are planning to stop breastfeeding at 5 o'clock, then maybe take him out to park, play with him, tell him story to distract him at that time. If this is not happening by you, take help of your partner, your parents, your siblings. They can pitch in for you. By the time you plan to stop breastfeeding, you can introduce sippy cups or glass, drinking by glass to water, so that whenever baby is demanding milk, you can offer him water in it. Especially during night weaning, this can be helpful, because baby would be in very sleepy mode, and when you offer something in sippy cup, he can just take few sips of it and sleep off. Higher the chances, but again every baby varies. And most importantly, be consistent, because if this varies, baby will not be able to understand what is happening, neither your body. So if you stop feeding one day at 5 o'clock, ensure that the same thing is followed nearly to 5 o'clock. Skip that feed, distract baby, play with him or do something. Keep consistency in this. If you skip 5 o'clock a feed one day, 8 o'clock a feed one day, your baby, your body, nobody would be able to understand it. So this is very important. Now we'll talk about few things which can be followed to ensure that the mother is not facing all the discomfort which comes along with it. I was telling that breast pain or engorgement and fever due to the pain, breast abscess, breast infection. There are few things which are scary, which come along with it, and how to avoid it, these tips can be followed. One is use a hot bag or warm compress on your breast before feeding, and post feeding you can use ice pack or take a cauliflower leaf, a big leaf, and freeze it and put it on your breast. This can give a bit of relief post feeding. Also, when you feel that there is too much of milk which is causing pain, express a bit. Do not express too much, because expressing too much gives an idea to your body and the signal telling that the baby is drinking, produce that much. So don't express too much, a little at a time. Now, massaging the breast can also help. If I have to explain in simple words, the milk does not come from one single pipe sort from breast. There are multiple milk ducts like this, if you can see it. So when a baby sucks, it is very normal that the milk flows from all the milk ducts. Sometimes, especially due to irregularity now while you are stopping to breastfeed, one of the duct gets blocked, and because of it there may be a form of infection there. Breast abscess can happen, which needs to be operated further. So to avoid this, massaging, hot compress will all help you. And avoid wearing tight clothes or tight bra. Use something supportive, easier, lighter on body, so that during this process that is not causing another problem. Also, a breast pad can be helpful. If you are a mother who is working and you are worried about the leakage, use a washable breast pad or use and throw a breast pad. A link to both of this is given in the description, so you can purchase it from that. Now, finally, in case you ask, how long would it take, when would it dry up? It varies. Now, what form you are following, it depends on that. And in case you are following the ideal method of mother-led gradual weaning, then it varies, because every baby is different. For one baby who takes 15 feeds a day, he may need 1 month to stop breastfeeding. Other baby may need 15 days. So again, it can be vice versa. So every baby is different. It can not be predicted now. Again, another question is, how long would it take to dry up? Between 7 to 10 days it would take. So I think I have covered a lot of details in this video. In case I have missed on something, please comment and let me know. I would try to answer or make a full-fledged video again. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that your journey, weaning journey, is it cannot be great. It will be a emotional phase for both of you, but I wish you good luck, a safe weaning journey for both of you, and we'll see you in yet another video. Please subscribe to my channel so that you get updates of all the videos I share with you. Bye bye, take care.